Hey, what's up everyone? This week, I want to show you a nice little trick in Xcode that is both super easy to understand and that should also help you save a lot of time. So let's take a look at the code I just pasted. As you can see, there are four lines in that code where I am setting the constraints of a subview. And now let's imagine that I need to apply the exact same modification to each of those four lines. For instance, let's imagine that I want to make it explicit that my view is a property of self. Of course, I could update each line individually. I could even save a little bit of time by doing some copy-pasting, but it turns out that in Xcode, there is actually a built-in way to update the four lines even faster than this. So let me revert my changes. And now instead of updating those four lines individually, I'm actually going to update them all at once by using Xcode's multiple cursors feature. So how does this work? I just need to press the Ctrl and Shift key and then hit the down arrow. And as you can see now at the beginning of each of the four lines, there is a cursor that is blinking. And whenever I'm going to write text, it's going to write text at the beginning of each of the four lines. So let me do it. And as you can see, I've been able to update the four lines all at once. So as you can see, this is quite the useful feature whenever we need to update boilerplate code. But it gets even better than this. Because now let's say I want to update the argument that's passed to the method constraint equal to. What I can do is that I can keep the Option key pressed, and as I move my cursors, you can see that the cursors are now moving after each symbol, even though the symbols have different length on each line. And by doing this, I can reach the first argument of the method. And for instance, let's say that I want my layout to be not relative to the view, but rather to the layout margin guide. I can position my cursors after the view, and then I can do dot layout margins guide. And that's it. Once again, my four lines have been updated, and it took very little time and effort to do so. And as you can imagine, there are tons of situations where multiple cursors can be super helpful. So let me show you a couple other examples. As you can see, this time I've pasted the code for a simple decodable struct. And this time, what I want to do is to customize the coding key for the property phone number right here. So what I have to do is, of course, start implementing the enum coding keys. And as I'm sure you've already experienced, writing the coding keys for an enum is quite a tedious task because we basically need to create a case in the enum for each decodable property of the struct. And of course, this is a perfect use case to use multiple cursors. So just like before, I'm going to create my three multiple cursors by holding the Ctrl and Shift key and hitting the down arrow key few times. Then I'm going to hold the Option and Shift key in order to select the name of the three properties. I'm going to copy that code. Then I'm going to move my cursor to my coding keys. I'm going to paste my code. Now using Option, I'm going to move my three cursors. I'm going to remove the keyword let and replace it by the keyword case. And now I can finally implement the feature I needed, which is to customize the coding key for the property phone number. Okay, so moving on to the last example I want to show you. As you can see in this code, I'm calling the init of CGWrite. And I chose to call this init because it's a method that actually takes quite a good number of arguments. There are four of them, and maybe this code is not as readable as it could be. Maybe it would be better if each argument were to be on a line of its own. And as it turns out, that kind of small refactor is also a very good opportunity to leverage multiple cursors. But this time, we are going to do it slightly differently than before. In the last two examples, I was placing my multiple cursors using the arrow keys on my keyboard. And this time, we are going to place them using either the mouse or the trackpad. So the way it's gonna work is that first, I'm going to place my cursor where I want my first multiple cursor to be. Then I'm going to hold the Ctrl and Shift key, so just like before, and I'm going to click where I want to place my other multiple cursors. So I'm going to place one at the beginning of each argument and one before the last parenthesis. And now all I need to do is to hit the return key. And that's it. My code has been refactored, and now each argument is on a line of its own. And that's all I wanted to show you in this video. As we've seen, multiple cursors in Xcode is really one of these nice little tricks that is super easy to master and that is guaranteed to save you a lot of time in the future. As always, if you have any question, remark, or feedback about the video, please share it with me in the comments. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.